guys, today I feel so bad. I have a big headache, my God.
Same, I have fever and it's so bad.
Yeah, I haven't been sleeping well for some time. I think I have insomnia.
I have busy everything. I am not feeling well this day, guys. Same like you, I don't know why.
Have you ever thought about how often you use paracetamol in your life? And again, have you ever thought about how you abuse it? How consciously do you dispose of it the wrong way? Or how unconsciously you are releasing it into our seas?
This problem is getting out of hand. But I know who I should call. The Copybot Hunters teams.
As a first step, the team has long wondered how to assess pharmaceutical paracetamol pollution in our seas. Then, the flash of genius. They will have used the cutest creatures in the whole world, the calanoid copepods, as a bioindicators, testing two different forms of paracetamol, the pill form and the soluble effervescent tablets. Yes, but how did they do?
Firstly, a boat trip was organized in Costa Fjord to collect zooplankton samples. Then once back, the samples were filtered and acclimatized, providing continuous oxygen. After filtering the seawater, the team sorted out the calanoid copepods using stereo microscope, pipette, and a lot of good willpower, successfully managing to collect a total of 1,440 copepods.
Then finally, it was time to prepare the experiment. Plastic cups have been filled up with 30 copepods each and with different concentrations of paracetamol inside. After that, all have been placed on a laboratory shaker that run non-stop for 24 hours to mimic sea conditions.
Well, now let's see some results.
From our results, we can say that calanoid copepods can be used as bioindicators for paracetamol pollution in our seas. This organism seems to have still certain level of tolerance within the environmental concentration. However, we can say that we are not far from having serious consequences. Concerning instead the different type of drugs tested, the effervescent type seems to be more deadly, probably because being more dissolved, it has direct effect on the zooplankton.
Our work here is done, but there is still much to discover.
We feel so guilty to have tortured you for 3 days. But now you're free again in the sea and we wish you the best for the future.
Please stay alive for us. Don't die, please. Stay alive. Produce more and fill up the ocean with copepods.
Yay! Yay!